Damien Mills.
I'm Bobby Buchanan.
And I'm Darranique McClure. We're doing a group scene from The Hole by N.F. Simpson.
We ought to be able to work something out if we put our minds to it. He seems to be waiting for something.
He says he's queuing for dark glasses, for the radiance, in case he gets blinded.
Perhaps your eyesight's better than mine. Can you make out any radiance?
They have one available window, or so he says.
Ah. There may be others in the shadows down there, but you can distinctly make out two people.
They're playing some game.
They're playing dominoes.
In boxing gloves?
They're playing dominoes. You can see the double six. They are in his left hand.
We look over there, coming out of the corner.
He seems rather keyed up.
I wonder if that's the battle bombardier. Because if that's the battle bombardier, then the other one must be Spider. Wait till it comes out of the light. Yes, it is. It's the battle bombardier and Spider.
Splendid. That's the boxing gloves are coming for.
But not the shuttlecock.
We'll come to that.
You can always recognize the battler.
Snap!
You can always recognize the battle bombardier, even if you've never seen him before, because he's the only boxer who carries a dartboard around with him.
The other one's fighting. He's just coming out of his corner.
They'll probably limber up with the brisk 5 minutes of having families.
Keep your eyes fired. He's the one that focused on down there.
Is he the one with the dominoes poised?
Dominoes are blind. It doesn't even think. Oh. He's coming out. The seven of clubs. That's what you've got to keep your eye on.
He seems to be threatening them with it or something.
I tell you, the dominoes are blind. It doesn't mean a thing. I've seen him do that for sometimes 5 minutes at a stretch. Until he has his opponent practically mesmerized. In fact, he is mesmerized, more or less at the time the Spider does it. And then, whoosh, he's on with Mr. Rigdon. Never fails.
Snap.
He seems to be biding his time at the moment.
He knows what he's doing. What do you think of
him? He certainly seems to know what he's doing.
Spider knows what he's doing, believe me. Once he's got his eye on, I've known him to trump love all to double 20 and not a pawn out of breath. He'd clear 5'6" with as clean a backhand drive as you would see in a lifetime of snooker. I've seen those who've claimed to see him hold his opponent off with the ace of diamonds just long enough to reload his dice. And then perhaps he'd huff him 2 or 3 times just for the hell of it. And then you'd see. Then you'd see the real coup de grace. First, he'd come out behind his two rooks. He always came out with his two rooks. Then, he'd walk out very slowly, very unconcerned, as if it didn't matter today or tomorrow. Then you wouldn't see what happened next, except that the other fellow wasn't there. He'd look again, and he'd be picking himself out of bulk with Mrs. Gray and the grocer's wife.
Leave it to your left!
Leave with his what? He's in check.
One.
Hi, my name is MacKenzie Rigdon.
Hi, I'm Sapphire, Satori.
Hi, I'm Brooke, Horridge.
And today we'll be doing a group scene from The Crucible by Arthur Miller.
We'll discuss it. Abigail, what sort of dancing were you doing with Betty and Florence?
Why, common dancing is all. I do think I ought to mention that I saw a kettle in the grass where they were dancing, but that was only soup.
Soup? What sort of soup are in this kettle, Abigail?
Beans and lentils, I think, and...
Abigail, you did not notice, did you, any living thing in the kettle? A mouse, perhaps? A spider? A frog?
That frog jumped in. We never put it in.
It may be your cousin is dying. Did you call the devil last night?
I never called him. Tituba called him.
She called the devil? I just like to speak with Tituba. Goody Ann, will you bring her up? How did she call him?
I know not. She spoke Barbados.
When she called him, did you feel any strangeness? A cynical wind, perhaps, a trembling below the ground?
I didn't see no devil.
You cannot evade me, Abigail. Did your cousin drink any of the brew that was in that kettle?
She never drank it.
Did you drink it?
No, ma'am.
Did you but ask you to drink it?
She tried, but I refused.
Why are you concealing? Have you sold yourself to Lucifer?
I never sold myself. I'm a good girl. She made me do it. She made Betty do it. She comes to me every night and makes me drink human blood.
No, I give you chicken blood.
Woman, have you enlisted these children for the devil?
I don't talk with no devil.
Why can she not wait? Are you silencing this child?
I love me, Betty.
You have sent your spirit out upon these children, have you not?
She sent her spirit on me in church. She makes me laugh at prayer. She often laughed at prayer. She comes to me every night to make me go and drink blood.
You bet me in a conjure, Abby. She bet me in a charm.
I'll tell you something. She's always making me dream these corruptions.
Abby!
She comes to me every night. I hear her in my sleep, singing her Barbados songs, laughing, and tempting me with...
Right, I know.
Why did you come back with the devil?
I don't come back with no devil, ma'am.
You confess yourself. I will take you back and move you to your death, Kichiba.
This woman must be hanged. She must be taken and hanged.
I told him I didn't desire to work for him.
Who? The devil? Now, Tituba, I know that when we bind ourselves to hell, it's very hard to break with it entirely. You would be a good Christian woman, would you not, Tituba?
Hey, a good Christian woman.
And you love these little children?
I don't desire to hurt little children, ma'am.
And you love God, Tituba?
With all my being.
Now, God's holy name.
Bless him.
And to his glory.
Eternal glory. Bless him. Bless God.
Open yourself, Tituba. Open yourself and let God's holy light shine on you.
Oh, bless the Lord.
When the devil comes to you, does he ever come to another person? Perhaps someone you know. Someone from the village. Who came to you with the devil? 2, 3, 4. How many?
There was four.
Who built their names? Their names.
Oh, how many times he bid me kill you, Miss Hale.
Kill me?
He said, Miss Hale must be killed. Miss Hale, no goodly woman. Miss Hale, mean woman and no good woman, and he bid me rise out of bed and cut your throat. But I say no. I don't hate that woman. I don't want to kill that woman. But he said, you work for me, Tituba, and I make you free. I give you pretty dress to wear, and you're going to fly up high up in the sky, and you're going to fly back to Barbados. And I say, you lie, devil, you lie. And one stormy night, he came to me. He said, look, I got white people. And I looked, and there was Goody Good.
They're all good?
Amen. And Goody Osborne.
Take courage. You must give us all their names. How could you bear to see these children suffering? Look at them, Tituba. Look at their God-given innocence. Their souls are so tender. We must protect them, Tituba. The devil is preying on them like a beast upon the flesh of the pure lamb. God will bless you for your help.
I want to open myself. I want the sweet love of God. I want the sweet love of Jesus. I sold myself.
Who did you see?
I saw Sarah Good. I saw Good Osborne. I saw Bridget Bishop. I saw George Jacobs. I saw Martha Bellows. And I saw Goody Sarah. All of them with the devil.
The marshal. I'll call the marshal. Let the marshal bring irons.
Hi, I'm Jenae Anderson. I'm Katelyn Wichers. And we are going to be performing a duet scene from The Lady of the Camellias by Alexandre, Dumas. You would speak with me, madame? Yes, Armand, I... Proceed, madame. That was you exculpate yourself. No, Armand, it is not that. Do not, I implore you, recur to the past. You are right, madame. It covers me with too much shame. Have mercy, Armand. You see how weak and ill I am. Upon the verge almost of the grave. I cannot defend myself against your reproaches. And if I could, I would not. Listen to me, friend. Without anger, hatred, or contempt, Come on. Give me your hand. Never again, madame. Never. And if for this only you sent me, I have believed if the day would ever come where you would refuse the hand I tendered. But that is not now the question. Armand, you must depart. Return at once to your father's house. And why, madame? Because, should you stay, the result would be a duel with Monsieur Varville, and I should be the only one to suffer. And you would have proved myself a coward? What other counsel could I have expected from such a woman? Armand, I have scarcely strength sufficient left to tell how much during the last month I have suffered. My malady increases hourly. It is consuming and destroying me. In the name of our past love, shun me. Forget, if it be possible, my very name. Oh, I understand. You tremble less for the pistol shot I should deprive of your rich husband, cheat you of the wealth of which you played the traitress. My greatest fear, Armand, is that you might fall. Whether I live or die, what matters it to you? Had you fear in writing, Armand, forget me, I'm about to be another's. What cared for you then? But I live, you see, for vengeance. Do you believe that I would suffer, you and your accomplice, with impunity, to break my heart? No, madame, no. I'm again in Paris. The question is now between your wealthy suitor, the husband whom you are about to sell yourself, and the poor dope who, having lured to the eve of promised rapture, you then laughed at and discarded. I will kill him, madame. I swear that I will kill him. But Sir Parfil is innocent of all that has occurred. You love and are about to wed him. Sufficient that to make me hate him. You well know I love him not. That I never could love that man. Why then will you wed me? In heaven's name, Armand, ask me not that. I dare not answer. Then I will answer for you. You will wed him because you are a mercenary and a heartless fiend, prepared to sell your heart to the highest bidder, because you lacked the courage boldly to face the poverty, which with me you feared would be your portion. Because in short, the man whom you had sworn you'd love was valueless, when placed beside the horses of your carriage and the diamonds about your neck. Thank you.
Thank you.
My name is Kristen Gremillion. I am from Troupe 6022. I will be performing a solo musical theater piece, and I will be performing No Good Deed from Wicked by Stephen Schwartz. No good deed goes on. Jordan.
And I'm Jay Simons.
And we are from Troop 6022.
And we're going to be doing a duet scene from The Crucible by Arthur Miller.
What keeps you so late? It's almost dark.
I will plant it far out to the forest edge.
Oh, so it is done?
Aye, the farm is seated. The boys asleep?
They will be soon.
Pray now for a fair summer.
Aye.
Are you well?
I am. It is a rabbit.
Oh, is it? Cider?
Aye. You come so late, I thought you'd go to Salem this afternoon.
Why? I have no business in Salem.
Well, you did speak of going earlier this week.
I thought better of it since.
Mary warns that today.
Why? You weren't me forbidden to go to Salem anymore.
I bid her go. She raises her chin up like the daughter of a prince and says to me, I must go to Salem, Goody Proctor. I'm an official of the court.
Court? What court?
Aye, it is a proper court they have now. They sent four judges out of Boston, she says. Waiting magistrate for the general court. And at the head sits the deputy governor of the province.
Why, she's mad.
I would have gosh she were. There'll be 14 people in the jail now, she says. And they'll be tried, and the court have the power to handle them too, she says.
They never had.
The deputy governor promising if they'll not confess, John. Town's gone wild, I think. Mary Warren speak of Abigail as though she were a saint. To hear her. She brings the girls into the court, and where she walks, the crowd apart for her like the sea for Israel. And they bring people before her, and if Abigail scream and howl and fall to the floor, they'll clap into the jail for bewitching her.
Tis a black magic.
I think you must go to Salem, John. I think so. You must tell him it's a fraud.
Aye, it is. It surely is.
Let you go to his ego chamber. He knows you well. And tell her what she had said to you in her uncle's house last week. She said it had not to do with witchcraft, did she not?
Aye, she did. She did.
God forbid you keep that from the court, John. They must be told.
Aye, they must. They must. It is a wonder they believe her.
I would go to Salem now, John. Let you go tonight.
I will think on it.
You cannot keep it, John.
I know I cannot keep it. I say I will think on it.
Good. Let you think on it.
I am only wondering how I may prove what she told me, Elizabeth. If they think she's a saint now, I think it is not easy to prove her a fraud. And the town gone so silly. She told it to me in a room alone, Elizabeth. I am.
You were alone with her?
For a moment, ah.
Why then? Is it not as you told me?
For a moment, I say. The others come in soon after.
Do as you wish, then.
Woman, I not have your suspicion anymore.
I
not have it.
Then let you earn it.
You doubt me yet?
John, if it were not Abigail that you had to go hurt, would you falter now? I think not.
Now look, you.
I see what I see.
I'll not have your judgment anymore, Elizabeth. I have good reason to think before I charge fraud on Abigail, and I will think on it. Look to yourself before improvement, before you judge your husband anymore.
I do not judge you. The magistrate that sits in your heart is what judges you. I never thought you but a good man, John. Only somewhat bewildered.
Oh, Elizabeth, your justice would freeze beer.
Thank you.